Robert Johnson learned also that where one person might be out doing a little kitchen party and playing like this, and then meets up with another guy, and the two of them, they sing some harmonies, but the other guy, maybe instead of just echoing the same guitar part, would play, you know. And then the first guy is playing this rhythm, and the second guy is playing... quite a sound. Well, a lot of people started realizing, hey, if I can get my thumb to play the one, I can probably play that other stuff with my fingers. Bits and pieces of everything he had heard everybody else doing. And by the way, by this point, Tommy Johnson had gotten a recording contract and was well known. Also, a fellow named Lonnie Johnson was doing really well and was making records all over the place. Lonnie Johnson, who ended up ending the last part of his life, the last couple of decades of his life, just down the road from here in Hamilton, moved away from the States to get away from the racism of the South, and even though he was a recording star, he still had to face the segregation and racism in the South, so he came up and spent the last part of his life in Hamilton. So being that they were recording stars, Robert Johnson was now calling himself one of the Johnson boys, even though nobody was related at all, and it's just a clever advertising. But he's playing stuff like this. See, he's playing the parts that, you know, maybe some other duos are playing these two parts together. He's playing them all together by himself. And he's also playing stuff like one of my favorite songs by him. I think this is an incredible testimony to the power of the music that was coming from the South. To understand that Robert Johnson never got past a grade two education just by the fact that that he was black growing up in the South. By the time you're 8 years old, you're needed back out in the cotton fields to help support the family. And despite that, he wrote a song like this. Well, I fought her down at the station with a suitcase in my hand. Yes, and I followed her down at the station with a suitcase in my hand. Well, it's hard to tell, it's hard to tell, when all of your love is in vain and all of my love is in vain. Now when that train pulled in the station, I looked her in the eye. Yes, and when that train pulled in the station, was getting this incredible poetry, stuff you had to read between the lines.